Welcome everybody. This is Yoga Pilates Fusion. My name is Julie Singer, Northwestern Recreation. And I thought we'd start standing up tonight, getting warmed up with some knee lifts, arms up. And we're gonna do kind of a detox to flush out the system. And then we're gonna do some arm pulls added to those knee lifts. Let's do 8, 7, and then you can add a hop or a jump or just step side to side. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and then we'll add a twist, side to side. Twisting to the side for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and one more each side. Good, so the body's getting warmed up. We're gonna take about a second position here. Knees are gonna turn out. We're just gonna shift side to side and kind of open up the hips, the glutes, the whole body. Good, then we're gonna come down to center and we'll pulse here. Kind of in a horse position. Knees tracking over the toes for 3. Go as low as you can. 2, you can lift the heels. 1 or both, and 1. Then we'll take the hands to the knees, and we're gonna bring one shoulder in. Look away. Come to center and switch. Good. Then we're gonna come down, and we're gonna shift a little bit and add a toe tap, and then a knee lift. And then we'll take it out into a T. So let's do 8, 7, get that side booty working, those glutes, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's come back to center, shifting side to side, take it into arms into a T. And we'll step out to the other side. Add a knee lift for 8, 7, 6. Just getting the whole body warmed up. You can go fast or slow. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, let's just walk it out with a couple toe taps. Front to back for 8. Throw those arms, 7. Bring those shoulders in, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Let's come to the top of the mat. Let's have the feet turned out. And just do a cat-cow here, rounding the back, navel to spine, opening the chest, look up. 2 more times. Spine is your lifeline, keeping it super flexible. Then we're gonna walk out into our mat. Let's meet down in plank with the feet wide. And just do a couple knee taps from plank. Let's do 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, let's do a couple toe taps. Getting that side glute working again for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then let's press back down dog. Good, let's bend one knee at a time. Now your feet are more narrow than they were before. Kind of just pedaling the feet, audible exhale out through the mouth. You can bend both knees together and then let gravity do its work, bringing the heels down towards the earth. Shaking the head, yes and no. Shoulders roll away from the ears. And then we'll roll forward to plank. Draw the navel to the spine, look forward. Exhale, press back down dog. Do that again. Inhale forward to plank. Exhale down dog. One more time. Inhale to plank. And then as you exhale, left leg to the sky. Left knee to the nose. Left leg back, left leg to the tricep, left leg back, left leg across the body to twist, left leg back. This time, twist in triangle. So leg across the body, arm to the sky, stay high or drop down, chaturanga. Come back up, and we'll switch. Right leg to the sky, right knee to the nose, right leg back. Right leg, right tricep. Right leg back, right leg crosses the body to twist. Right leg back up, and then twist in triangle. Arm to the sky, drop down, chaturanga, or stay high. Exhale, come back to center. And as you inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale back. One more time, inhale forward to plank. Exhale back. We're gonna drop down to the knees. Stack the wrists underneath the shoulders. Just move the hips side to side. Kind of like C curve. Side to side, stretch through the hips. Come back to center. And we're gonna lift the knee up to the side and then back on an angle for four. Working that hips and the glutes. Three, two, and one. We'll do the other side up, straight up, and then back on an angle for four. Three, two, and one. Good. We're going to do big rainbow legs. We're going to take a stretch all the way to the front of the mat. Head to the floor, hips back. We're going to walk over towards that foot into that C curve. Back to center. And then we'll do our rainbows, looking over, C curve that way, to center for four. Three, get that twist in. Two. And one. Keep that heel back to the other side. Press back to take the twist. And come back to center. We'll switch to the other side. Leg out, take a deep full body stretch. Head towards the floor. Walk those hands all the way towards the foot to C curve. Walk back. And then take your twist. Big rainbow kicks. Up and over. Looking side to side for three, two, and one. Good. We're going to come back to center. We're going to lift the right arm to the sky. Look up. And then take that arm all the way under and take the left arm or take it over to bind into that twist. Back up to center and we'll switch. Reaching up to the sky, all the way under or around into any kind of a bind. And exhale. We're going to flip over onto our backs. Take a full body stretch. And then we will roll up, arms, head, neck, shoulders, whole body. Or you can do a half roll up with the knees bent. Let's do eight. Roll up and over for seven. Six. Five. Keep those legs together. Zip up those inner thighs. Four, three, two, and one. We're gonna stay forward, Paschimottanasana, seated forward fold, or you can take your feet wide or whatever allows you to get the best stretch. But then we're gonna sit up and just bring that right knee into the chest. Hugging it into the chest, Pavanuttasana to take the stretch. And then we're gonna turn it into the single leg stretch. We'll do the leg stretch series of Pilates. One hand to the ankle, one to the knee, and switch. Keeping the feet flexed, really drawing that knee into the chest for eight, seven, can also be down on the ground. And one more each side. Double leg stretch. Legs together, knees together, hands on the ankles, arms above the head for 8. Stretching and reaching, 7, whole body, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, legs as low as you can go, and 1, good, we're gonna catch. The left leg up is high towards the ankle, and switch, add a double pulse for 4, 3, keep reaching higher, 2, and last one each side. Good, knees into the chest. We're gonna roll like a ball. Hold on to the backs of the thighs and roll up. We'll sit to balance or hold the ankles. Maybe roll to the top of your mat. Chin to chest, roll back. Sit to balance for 4. Massage that spine. 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna stay on our backs and we're gonna do a crossover. We're gonna take our elbow to the opposite knee and switch for 4, feet are flexed. 3, 2, and 1. Good, we're going to roll up. We're gonna sit in Baddha Konasana, the bound angle, sit up really, really tall, or maybe have the hands behind you, wherever you can get the deepest stretch, or come to that forward fold and take a breath. Good, on the next inhalation, you're gonna take your legs wide, sit up for the side stretch, one arm under, one arm over, rotating, spiraling your chest to the sky, opening up that whole side body. Good, and we will switch. Other side, spinning that chest up, rotating the body and breathing. Good, we're gonna come over to hands and knees. Do another transition of cat-cow. Then we will press back, down dog, and come to the top of the mat and take a forward ragdoll stretch, holding on to the elbows or letting the arms hang down. Then we will slowly roll up, arms to the sky. Exhale, forward fold, right leg back, left leg back. We'll go knees, chest and chin, or you can do a chaturanga. Press back, down dog. Right leg to the sky, right knee to nose, right foot forward, low lunge. We're gonna rock forward and back to open that hip a little more and twist. One arm's gonna reach to the sky, then we will switch. You can also drop your left knee to the ground. Hug that shoulder into the knee to twist to the other side. Good, we're gonna bring that knee to the earth. Come into a low crescent. Take the breath. And we're gonna turn that into half camel. So reach the left hand back to the left leg, the right arm to the sky for your back bend. Good, then we'll bring both hands here. We'll step back and switch to the other side. Take your twist. Cradle that hand inside, shoulder to knee. Open up to balance. Good, come back to center, drop the knee. Anjaneyasana, open the chest. And then straddling out into half camel on the other side for your back bend. Good, on the next inhalation, bring that left foot into the center of the mat and shift both hips back, bringing that left hip firmly back to open the hips more into the half splits. Good, then we'll come onto a standing split, right leg to the sky, and switch. Left leg back, left knee down, right foot flexes, right hip draws back, coming into standing splits. Inhale, step all the way back. We'll square the hips and come into warrior one. Take a deep full breath here. Shifting into warrior two, expanding, taking a side angle. And a triangle. Taking a deep full breath, arm to the sky, crown of the head forward, and we'll switch. Come back, knees, chest, and chin, or your chaturanga. Left leg up, left knee to the nose, left foot forward. We'll take warrior one, squaring the hips, ankle to arch, arms to the sky, look up. Exhale, warrior two, arms are parallel, side angle. Breathing into that side body that we opened on the floor. And then stretching that leg into triangle, Tita Trikonasana, with the breath. Adding on Ardha Chandrasana, the balancing pose. Bending the left knee, taking the hand outside that foot, shifting both hands to the floor, or elevating the right arm to the sky to balance. Taking the hand down, and we'll switch. Ardha Chandrasana, the balancing half moon on the other side. Good, let's step back. Take a vinyasa or hold down dog. Audible exhale out through the mouth. Right leg to the sky. Right knee to the nose. Right knee forward into pigeon. If you have any pain here in your knee or your ankle, you're going to flip onto your back for figure four. So either pigeon or figure four. Stretching your leg back, looking that your leg is exactly behind you, squaring off those hips. Your foot can be close to the body or close to the front of the mat, whatever allows your hips to square. And then if you like the sleeping pigeon, you will take a forward fold, deepening into your stretch. Audible exhale out through the mouth. So whichever knee is bent, you will feel a stretch on that outer hip or anywhere else you feel it. Then if you want to walk over towards that foot and press away to deepen the stretch. And then we will step back. Take that right leg to the sky with external rotation. We'll bend that knee. And then we will switch. Opposite leg, left leg to the sky, standing up, knee to nose, flipping onto your back or taking pigeon. Now that foot can be underneath the body or out to the side. Squaring off the hips, checking that the back knee and toe are exactly behind you. Coming into your back bend or taking that sleeping pigeon. And you want your third eye point, that point between the eyebrows, on the floor, squaring off those hips. And to deepen the stretch, you can walk in the direction of the foot to breathe. Two more breaths. Good, then slowly coming back to center. We're gonna come into our widest angle, staying down here on the floor. Upavishta Konasana, our wide angle, hands are back. We're gonna walk our hands forward to see if that deepens the stretch, or to the floor, to the feet, or take a complete forward fold to stretch those inner thighs wherever you feel the stretch for three full breaths. Two, and one. Good, we're gonna roll over onto one side to do some side kicks, hand under the head. We're gonna take our feet straight to the front of the mat. Stack the hips, one hand in front, and we're gonna take that leg up and down for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. We're gonna keep that leg up and we're gonna do tiny circles to really isolate that glute for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. And we're gonna take that foot all the way forward and then a really big stretch so you can reach the wall behind you without moving your torso. And then we'll do that forward and back for four, three, two, and one. We're gonna catch a hold of that back foot. Bring that foot, bend it, that foot towards the glutes to stretch. And then pull the foot away to deepen into your back bend. But then we're gonna come onto our belly to take a swim. We're gonna do opposite arm and leg, either fast or slow, for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Head down, we'll do inner thigh beats, just beat the legs together. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Press up, and we'll do the other side. So flip over onto your other side. Side kicks, seat to the front of your mat, head under your hand, and leg up and down for 8, 7, 6, straight up. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Little circles, dime-sized circles to the back of the mat, leading with the heel for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. That foot's gonna come all the way forward and then all the way back to stretch. Touch that wall behind you. And then we'll kick forward for 4 and back. See if you can keep your torso really strong. 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna take that foot back, bend that knee, grab a hold of it, bring it to stretch the quad all the way into the glute. And then kick it back into the hand to deepen into the back bend. Good, then we're gonna roll onto our belly for Dandurasana or the rocking stretch. So holding onto one or both ankles, flexing the feet. We'll rock forward and back and side to side. 3, whatever feels good to you. 2, and 1. Good. We're going to press into child's pose with the toes together and the knees wide. Stretching the arms forward, opening into those hips. Resting the forehead on the floor. And then we're going to walk all the way over to one side and press the hips away to stretch. Walk back to center, stretch to the other side. And then we're gonna roll over onto our backs and we'll do a twist. We're going to bring the knee into the chest. Then we're gonna twist and cross the knees or double twist, whatever feels good to you. And then we're gonna turn the torso all the way away. So the torso will go towards the front and the knees and the twist to the back. Just stretch the spine. Coming back to to center, we'll come into figure four, flexing the ankle at the knee, stretching here, holding on wherever you can. And then we'll switch figure four on the other side. Turning that into a twist. And the torso revolves to the other side. Breathing in. And breathing out. Coming back to center. We will come into a bridge pose. So have the feet about shoulder distance, lifting up the hips. Bring the hands underneath, roll up onto the shoulders. Knees are high. We'll bring the thighs in abduction towards each other for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. 2, and 1. We're gonna slowly roll down. And we're gonna bring one leg to the sky. We're gonna do our leg circles. Down, around, up, and stop for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Reverse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Scissor the legs, down, around, up, and stop for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and reverse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Bring those knees into the chest. I'd like you to waterfall the feet or work up into a shoulder stand. Not a lot of looking around or swallowing. Lengthening and breathing here for 3, 2, and 1. Maybe taking your legs overhead to the plow pose. And then slowly rolling down onto the floor as slow as you can go. So we're gonna take the feet as wide as the mat, drop the knees in, and just rotate the neck to one side, pressing the low back into the floor. Rotate the neck to the other side. Then lift up the head. Make sure the head is firmly on the floor. If you have any discomfort in your back, keep the knees bent. If not, we'll just do a short Shavasana because we'll end standing, legs out, palms up. Come to your most comfortable position and close your eyes and take a deep, full breath in. A deep full breath out. Just noticing how the body feels. Noticing the depth of the breath. Scanning the body. Breathing deeply for the next 5 deep inhales and 5 deep exhales. Good, and when you're ready, stretch your arms overhead. Bring your legs together, take a full deep body stretch. Exhale, bring your knees into the chest. Rock a little bit side to side. We'll roll over to one side. Coming up to a comfortable seat. Take a deep full breath here. And rock up to standing. In a very yogic way, I was gonna end seated, but in a more Pilates way, I'll end standing. So heels together, zipping up the inner thighs. Inhale and exhale, hands to the heart center. This has been your Pilates Yoga Fusion, your 30-minute NU recreation class. I'm Julie Singer. Namaste.